Hey guys, Merry Christmas. It's Christmas in San Francisco. We have little Jax, just woke up, Lydia, getting ready to take Jax out on his morning run. It's supposed to rain today. There's a storm coming into San Francisco. There's a couple actually coming this week and next week. But the thing about having a Vizsla or any active dog is no matter how rainy it is or what the weather is like, doesn't matter, you still gotta take him out or take her out. So when it rains, typically wear a hoodie just for warmth, and then on top I have this Helly Hansen waterproof raincoat that goes basically to past my knees. So it's just like this long raincoat that keeps me dry. And then we both have waterproof boots that we wear. Jax is chewing a box. Hey boy. But he usually doesn't wear any sort of coat. He'll be fine, especially if he's running around, and you can just dry him off before he gets home. See you guys on the hike. Hey everyone, just got to Fort Funston, which is on the west shore of San Francisco. I don't know if that's the best way to describe the location, but man, it's beautiful. I think you could probably surf that break. We're just lucky to have so many different parks like this in a nearby city setting, right? It took us about 10 minutes to get here. It's Christmas Day, so there really wasn't any traffic. But it's not always easy to find a good dog park. There's often a lot of dog parks around, but not all of them are great for hunting dogs like Jax, especially in small confined dog parks. Just not enough space. Some dogs and owners can be a little bit more protective. But this is awesome. You can see other dogs running around. I don't know if you can see it here, but it's just a big wide open space. There's a beach trail that we'll get to later. Sand, it's cool. This is a really great place to be. Jax, what? But it's really awesome, yeah, and you can get great views. So that's Sutro Tower. It's just amazing. Awesome place here.
They say that I wasted potential, meant to make my days all eventful, but sometimes I can't help but stay at buds to cope with my mental. She says that I'm kind and I'm gentle, but really I'm just scared to be alone. Maybe if I tell you that I hate you, then you'll give me my space. Maybe if I say I love you, then you'll throw it back in my face. I'm a homebody, don't owe nobody nothing. Thought she was bluffing, but she really took my breath away. Dreamt about it yesterday. I'm a homebody, don't go nobody's functions. And she come to the junction just to take my breath away.
So what is everyone else doing on Christmas Day? Lydia and I kind of took it easy this year. We've been getting each other small gifts here and there leading up to today, so we didn't have a big gift opening morning, which is really nice. We're also spending our first holidays together alone in San Francisco. Usually we either go to her parents' house, which is in Portland, or my family's house, which is in Hawaii. But this year we're just staying put, which is really nice. And it's nice to start off the morning outside in nature with your dog in a pretty quiet morning. But yeah. Jackson's getting better and better at fetching. He didn't quite understand how to do it for a long time. He would kind of go and run and get the ball and sniff it and wouldn't bring it back. But what we realized is there are certain balls that dogs really like. So for example, a typical tennis ball, at least Jax doesn't really find too much interest in it. And if anything, he'll just bite the fuzz off. But if you ever see those orange and blue balls that are more rubbery, he really likes those balls. And most dogs do.
Yeah, exactly. This is the one.
So usually they're coupled with that throwing stick. But the way we got ours is we actually found them at a park at Chrissy Fields. Tall grass. I've lost a couple balls out there. We found these. Great condition. We just started throwing and Jax loved it. So we stuck to those. And I think yesterday we went to Chrissy Field in the morning. It was really one of the first times we've ever seen Jax play fetch. And it was amazing. You get a lot of exercise. So it's pretty awesome. My office closed down from December 24th to January 4th, so that gives us about 13 days of time off, and we're really fortunate for that. My wife took the same time off. And sometimes you don't know when you need a break until you take a break from work. It's so easy to get caught up in all the stuff you're doing every day and caught up in these self-imposed deadlines, and you kind of lose track of what's important in life, which includes spending time with your family and getting out and being in nature. So I'm really thankful to have this time off. I hope everyone can also have a little bit of a break. Take time to get outside. Breathe a little bit, right? Are you happy you took a break, Lydia?
So happy.
Lydia had to take time off next week, which means that she had to crank a little bit harder this week to get ahead of things.
But we did it. It feels so good.
So good. And time goes by fast, so you just have to really appreciate the time you have.